I hope that all is possible to see. My name is Grzegorz Leszczuk, as you know from the chairman of the session. The title of the paper is Crack Growth Rate Deceleration Effect in Constructional Steel Caused by Artificial Crack Closure Effect. So it's a kind of continuation of the discussion between crack closure and the fatigue crack growth. This paper is a fruit of cooperation between four universities, so University of Porto, in person of Professor José Cojeira and Professor Abilio de Jesus, as well as IPM, so it's the Institute of Physico-Mechanical Institute in Lviv, in Ukraine, in both main authors, Professor Hihori Nikiforch and Professor Olha Zwilko, as well from the same name, IPM, Institute of Physics of Materials, and the Brno University of Technology from Czech Republic, in the name of Stanislav Seid, and also our team from Wrocław, from Poland, from my laboratory, Duda Szymon and Paweł Zielonka. Maybe I start from the short agenda of my presentation. The first point is the motivation for analysis of the crack deceleration, fatigue crack growth rate deceleration methods. The second point I'd like to say, maybe not about the materials, but about the one material which was used in the experimental campaign and the methods. And the next point will be about the results of fatigue crack growth rate results and also expected deceleration effect. And as final will be about summary and conclusions. Let me allow to perform some retrospective analysis of the beginning of my research interest from the old steel structures. And we have a lot of problems with the cracks in old bridges and also especially in long-term operated paddle iron from 19th century, from early 20th century. And of course, we can try to overcome some problems with the cracks using bolted connections or maybe by welding. However, in some cases, as you can see, we have a really, really challenging problem with these structures and also repairing methods, because sometimes it's difficult to drill and also it's not easy to bolt the connections, and also hot riveting is not also possible to perform in various long-term operated structures. And also the same case is for the welding. So in case of the old steels, we have a problem with non-metallic inclusions, and also in pipelines, we have risk of explosion. So recently we explored oh my God, it's 2017. So I'd like to say that the time is going so fast from the conference to conference. So let's see that in previous conference also, international conference of structural integrity, we've presented two papers devoted to rehabilitation of old steels using composite patches with full face or strips, as well as we started to test some experimental parts with the cross effect. So I think that it is a kind of electroplasticity, so artificial clock closure by combined thermal and electric method, as you can see. Of course, all types of repairments has wide advantages and disadvantages. And then in this case, I'd like to show you something different. Maybe it will be continued in engineering practice, but maybe not. You can see now it's after the some experimental results. I selected with my team for the testing R260 grade steels. It's typical rail steel. The microstructure of this steel is typically perlitic. And this steel is, of course, commonly used in rail. But we use this type of steel as for the competitive material for experimental campaign, which was originally started from the Ukrainian research team on the very, very mild steel. So we would like to see what happens in the steel, which is more, maybe not so ductile like S355 steel. And I'd like to say about the methods. In our case, we used typical compact tension specimens with the main width of the specimen near to 50 millimeters. And we use different strengthening strategies. Of course, we used the composite patches. We used also stop hole technique. And as I'd like to underline, quite new experimental patented fluid activation as a deceleration inhibitor. So it's a kind of injection methods for the cracks. And as you can see, we started with the ordinary experimental campaign using typical servo-hydraulic MTS testing machine. And of course, initially all specimens were pre-cracked to the same initial fatigue crack length. And then we started with the experimental campaign using constant loading amplitude type of loading. And we measure, of course, compliance, and we calculate crack closure, etc., etc. So all what is normal for the typical fatigue crack growth rate test. However, in the case of one group of specimens, we used the fluid, and the fluid was injected by hand, and of course not automated. So therefore, maybe it was not so perfect, but gave us promising results for the next stage of the experiment. Maybe we can focus on the experimental results. If you can see in the specimen which were tested with the maximum loading force equal 8 kilonewtons with the constant stress ratio on the level 0.1, we started with the specimens without any extra procedure from 14 millimeters up to 22 millimeters. Which took more or less 75,000 of cycles. And then we started with the fluid injection, and the fluid was injected from 75,000 of cycles up to 140 number of cycles. And then, of course, we stopped the injection, and the crack growth in the same manner as for normal specimen you can see in the stop hole. Stop hole, of course, is one of the oldest repairing techniques, but we used it for comparison. And of course, as published before, a lot of solutions with the composite patches gave us similar results with one strip, so full face strips, and it was caused by reducing of the stress intensity factors. What was interesting for us, because the fluid, the organic fluid patented by our Ukrainian colleagues was used not so often in experimental campaign and is still under the test. We started, as you can see, in pure metal. We have in rail steel normal behavior of the A diagram versus delta K. And of course, after the injection, we can observe for the constant load amplitude a significant decrease in the fatigue crack growth rate. It's more or less higher than 10 times. And then, of course, you can see the crack starts to grow in the same manner as before the injection. You can see also in the macroscopic view from scanning electron microscopy fractography study, the wet zone. The wet zone is the zone where was the fluid activated. And of course, when the fluid is dried, the crack starts to grow in normal direction. Of course, from the microscopical point of view, this phenomenon could be on the crack surface. So therefore, with Professor Nicky Fortune, we called this phenomenon artificial crack closure. So the typical crack driving force was decreased, and of course, it was a result of crack deceleration method. And of course, we tried to confirm this phenomenon by measurement of crack closure parameter, originally formulated by Elber. You can see using compliance methods, we calculate the crack opening point. And of course, after the fluid activation on the level 22 millimeters, we can see the significant drop of the crack driving force, and of course, which means that the delta K effective was significantly smaller than delta K applied. Of course, a similar phenomenon was observed in a completely different type of salt, maybe not fully completely, but different types of steel. It was a steel close to S355 grade, and this test was done in Ukraine and published in the paper of International Journal of Fatigue. And you can see the same effect, but the contour of the test was completely different, because in our case, we tested at the constant load amplitude, and you can see that we have constant delta K value. So therefore we can observe different behavior, but the same rule was for different stages of the crack. And of course, from the microscopic point of view, you can see the oxidation layer between crack surfaces. And of course, the significant decrease of the Elbert parameter from 0.86 up to 0.1. Maybe as a final conclusion, I would like to try compare different strategies. And of course, the fluid activation method was very interesting and of course promising approach. However, it is still under the experimental campaigns, on the way from the theoretical and experimental application up to engineering application is quite long. So we would like to test with different types of materials. And of course, more comprehensive describe the phenomenon, the local phenomenon which exist in the crack tip. And of course, we would like to try to use different type of existing knowledge of the crack closure and models for the prediction of fatigue crack growth rate using crack closure. So in our case, artificial crack closure phenomenon caused by oxidation layer. Thank you very much for your attention. And of course, I will check